In the ultimate showdown between managing road intersections, we ask which is better, the mighty roundabout or the four-way stop? Both have their advantages and disadvantages, but at the end of the day, which is faster and more efficient? Let's take a look. Roundabouts are pretty ubiquitous in the UK, whereas four-way stop intersections are the USA's go-to strategy for moving traffic across road intersections. For drivers from either country, the other's solution seems completely absurd and inefficient. In the United States, engineers adopted the four-way intersection as they believe them to be much safer and more efficient. Across the pond, British engineers believe the roundabout was the way to go. But it is not just the UK. Many Western European countries also adopted roundabouts in the mid-1950s. Of the two, many professional engineers today believe the roundabout is hands down the safer intersection design when compared to signals or controlled stop intersections, such as four-way stops. But for many North American drivers, the roundabout can be an intimidating and frankly alien concept. Surely those pesky roundabouts aren't that much better, are they? What is needed is some form of objective test to settle this once and for all. There certainly must be numerous scientific studies comparing them. And as it turns out, there most certainly are. One example, a PhD engineering thesis by Vincent Spar at the University of Dayton, Ohio, compared the operational performance and safety of both types of intersection. Spar studied the relative performance of roundabouts and traditional intersections, like four-way stops in Dublin, Ohio. He also looked at the historical crash data for the region for different intersections and roundabouts to compare how the two performed. His results were enlightening, to say the least. It turns out, by Spar's estimation, that roundabouts proved to operate better than their alternatives up to a certain capacity. During peak hours, the roundabouts clearly won out regarding the number of vehicles that were able to navigate them to a point. Beyond around 3,000 vehicles an hour, roundabouts were not significantly better than traditional intersections. Beyond this, there was no marked improvement over traditional intersections with regards to the amount of vehicles passing through the intersection in a given time period. But it gets more interesting when it comes to safety. Crash numbers were not significantly lower at roundabouts, but injury rates were less severe. Pedestrians were also safer at roundabouts, showing a lower risk of being injured because of the tendency to have split islands between lanes, along with entries and exits. This means they only have to tackle one direction of traffic before reaching the islands. Past studies also seem to agree with these findings, supporting the reputation that roundabouts have around the world as being safer than their four-way alternatives. But is there any real reason why? As it turns out, roundabouts have three main characteristics that make them safer and more efficient. They are as follows. 1. Roundabouts eliminate or alter driver conflict types. As roundabouts have a central island, all drivers must travel in the same direction. In other words, you can't turn in front of oncoming vehicles, either legitimately or by running red lights. 2. Roundabouts force drivers to reduce speeds in order to navigate them. As you can imagine, this has clear and present benefits for safety. 3. Because of the two previous points, crashes, when they do occur, are less severe. So the results are in. Roundabouts appear to be the more superior choice of the two, and other engineers tend to agree. But does this mean that the USA and other roundabout-phobic countries will change their ways and adopt the roundabout? Only time will tell.